This is the PowerG Wireless Outdoor Magnetic Contact with Auxiliary Input. A robust device for both residential and high-volume commercial use. With its unique two-way communication, long-life batteries, and weatherproof design, it is perfect for protecting outdoor entries or exits, including perimeter gates, pool and garden enclosures, shed doors, windows, and more. To mount the device, the contact needs to be placed above the door or window on the fixed frame, while the magnet needs to be attached to the movable part of the door or window, making sure that the contact and magnet pointers face each other. Please check the installation instructions for range coverage guidelines. Insert a flathead screwdriver into the slot on the device here, and push upward to remove the decorative cover. To activate the magnetic contact, you first need to configure the control panel to learning mode. Next, pull the enrollment tab to start the auto-enrollment process. Please note, if you enroll the device to a wireless panel with a version that does not support the device ID, it will be recognized with a different ID number. Now unscrew the lower screw from the device's cover and separate the device from the bracket. The contact can be installed with the back tamper or without. If you do not want back tamper protection, mark and drill the two outermost holes at the very top and bottom of the device. If you do want back tamper protection, as recommended in the installation instructions, mark and drill four holes and screw in the bracket with the four screws provided. Now reattach the device to the bracket. Secure the contact with a screw and reattach the decorative cover. Mark and drill two holes and screw in the magnet bracket. Mount the magnet bracket to the surface. To connect the contact with another nearby device via the auxiliary input, start by removing the jacket at the end of the cable to expose the wires. Remove the contacts bracket and perforate the silicon gasket at the back of the device with a 0.8mm or 0.03-inch pin. Pass each wire through an entry hole and out the opposite side. Connect each wire to the relevant terminal and screw the terminal closed using a screwdriver. Put back the contacts bracket and reattach the screw. Replacing the batteries on an installed device is easy. Start by inserting a flathead screwdriver into the slot provided and push upward to remove the device's decorative cover. Unscrew the top screw from the battery cover. Remove the batteries, and after 1 minute, insert two new 1.5-volt lithium batteries. Make sure the batteries are facing the correct direction. Now reattach the battery cover with a screw. Enclose the device's cover. The anti-mask feature detects sabotage attempts, like obstruction of the sensor. Please note, it only works with selected panel versions. To receive an alert when something interferes with the magnet, the anti-mask function must be activated in the control panel. You can check the installation instructions for guidance. To begin, position the device and magnet pointers to face each other, like this. There are two options for positioning the device and magnet. You can place both facing upwards, or the magnet can be facing the device. The device and magnet must be positioned at the same height for the anti-mask feature to work properly. Press and hold the enroll button for 6 to 8 seconds to start the anti-mask learning process. Release the button only once the green LED lights up. The light will take about 2 seconds to change from yellow to green, and stays green for about 2 seconds, so you'll need to immediately release the enrollment button. During this process, the device and magnet must remain stable in the same position for 10 seconds. The green light will flash 3 times to indicate successful calibration. In case of failure, the red light will flash 3 times. In that case, repeat the process from the beginning.